joining me. I hope you are having a lovely Friday so far, even though it is still early, it's 10 o'clock. If you did just join in with the Little Ones class, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed coming on safari with us. It's always fun and games on a Friday morning. It's bank holidays. I was just saying to the Little Ones, three reasons to be happy. One, it's PE day. So I hope you are doing something really nice today. Number two, it's a bank holiday. Woo! And three, it is the weekend. So triple the reason to be happy and smiley this morning. Well done you for deciding to take 30 minutes out of your Friday to give yourself a little bit of a ballet workout. Well done, guys. Okay, so we are going to get started. So if this is your first time in joining this class, it's a very low impact ballet class. So it's more along the lines of a stretch class, but obviously following the foundations of a classical ballet structure. So you will notice I don't have a chair, I don't have a ballet bar. I like us to focus on our core muscles, so your abdominal muscles and your glutes being your bar, and that's where your strength is coming from. If you were watching on Monday and Wednesday this week, you will recognize some of the exercises because I will be repeating some of them, especially the port de bras and the adage. So hopefully you might remember that. I will do one aerobic exercise, so one Allegro jumping exercise. If you do have any knee, hip, ankle injuries, or perhaps knee, lower back pain, maybe sit that one out. But what I would say is from now to the end of the class, don't give in to your posture. So keep the posture up nice and tall. And then at the end, we can have a nice relax and we can let it all go at the end, okay? So the class is going to be about 25 minutes in duration. So let's get started, guys. We're going to place our feet into our first position. As you're standing here, push the shoulders back, zip up the stomach muscles and squeeze in the inside thigh. So that's right there. We're going to place that right toe lower down into your second position. Today, we're going to start our plié exercise, but with a rise and a port de bras, open the arms. We're going to take a demi and a stretch, another demi and a stretch from here. We're going to take a full plié, drive the heels through the floor with a port de bras and stretch, rise and lower. So that's a quick test, point and close. We take rise, port de bras, two demi pliés, one full plié, rise, lower, same thing but with the left foot, and we'll repeat. I will call it out and I'll do the whole thing with you, everybody, so nothing to worry about. Let's get going. So, pulling up the knees. Let's go. First position, lower to second position. And we go, rising up. Find the balance. Open them to the side as you lower the heels. All right, two demi pliés. Keep the elbows lifted. Up. And plié. And up. Full plié with a port de bras. Heels stay on the floor. Okay, rise. And lower. Point that toe. Close into your first position. Inside thighs, make sure they're squeezing. Let's go. One. Two. Open the arms. Find the balance. Great job. Nice control. Plié. Inside thighs, bring them together. Full plié. Let's go. Down. Push those knees out. Heels down on the floor as soon as you can. Take your rise up. Test the balance. And lower. Great job, guys. Point the left toe. Arms down. We're halfway. Let's go again. Lifting up. Heels up. Check your weight is forward on the balls of your feet. If that rise is too much for you, just take the port de bras via flat feet. Full plié, heels stay on the floor for this one. Knees out. Rising up. And lower. Well done, last time. Point that left toe. Okay, here we go. Arms should be aching now. Stomach's in. And plié. And stretch. Plié. And stretch. Here we go. Full plié. Down. Push those knees out. Heels down. Great job, guys. Well done. Lift those knees up. Feet, heels up. Try not to wobble like me. Lower them down and stand tall. Good job. Well done. Very nice, everybody. So you should now already feel a lovely kind of warmth in your upper arms and in your quadricep muscles as well. If you do, great job. That means your exercise is starting to work for you. So let's move on 2, our Battement Tendu and Retiré exercise. I did this on Wednesday and Monday with you as well. And it's something actually that I like to incorporate with the primary class. It's all about transfer of weight and finding our balance on one leg, which as a dancer in ballet is pretty important. So let's take our arms out to second. From first to the front and close. So keeping the hips, don't let the hip move with your leg. Keep it back and close. 2 tendus, then front. Lift it up and point and close to the side. Same. And 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. Lift it up and place and close. We go with the left, front, and 2, 3, and 4. 1, lift it up and point and close and side, side, side. Okay, we're gonna do it 4 times. Sorry, we're gonna do it 2 times through, but 4 times on 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're gonna find our balance. So pointing that toe and try and just stay in your retiré position, visualizing your head going up through your ceiling, your heel driving through the floor, and your knee pushing out to the side. So you've got 3 points to think of. 1, 2, 3, okay? Create like a triangle with your body. Let's go for it, everybody. I will talk you through the entire thing. So feet in first position, arms to second. We go front, 2. Here we go, retiré. Down the middle. If I just wanted to lift one leg off the floor, I have to transfer my weight, otherwise that's going to happen. So I really have to transfer it so I'm able to lift that leg. Great job, everybody. Okay, I'm just going to move my mat forward a little bit so I've got a bit more room. For your pot de bras and your adage, we're actually going to start up in the corner. Like I said, if you were watching Monday, Wednesday, you might well recall this. So go to the corner of your room, away from your screen, and you're gonna stand on your downstage legs. I also spoke a little on Wednesday about stage direction, because I'm quite aware that I say downstage, upstage quite a lot, and I think some of you may think, oh my goodness, what is Sarah going on about? Downstage would be closer to me right now, so closer to your screen, and upstage would be going to the back of the stage, so going away from your screen. There you go. If you didn't know, you have just learned something new about stage direction. So downstage and upstage. Downstage, foot closest to your screen. Step on the upstage foot, the downstage foot, and take your arms to second. From here, leave the foot where it is and sweep your upstage arm, so that's your back arm, your downstage arm, and here I want to see that back arm. So try and get a lovely rotation in your spine and back to here. Find the balance. We're gonna lift that leg up off the floor to your arabesque, and then we're gonna try and rise up but close that foot into the back. We're gonna take a pitter-patter, or a bourée as the correct terminology is, and bourée backwards. Careful you don't hit something behind you. Standing on your other downstage croisé foot, ready to do it on the other side. 2, open the arms. Take the back arm forwards. Now let's see the back stretch and twist through the spine and lift. We're gonna lift that leg to your arabesque. Rise up, close it behind, pitter-patter around, and bourée back. Okay, we're gonna go for it 4 times through. I will call it out the whole way through, apart from the last time. I won't say anything, so we can just listen to the music and dance. And if you go wrong, it doesn't matter. Just try and really feel the leg stretching, finding the balance, which we just spoke about. And on this bit, try as best you can to get that back arm forward, so you can feel that lovely bit of rotation through the centre of your spine. Okay, everybody, here we go. So standing on your downstage foot, we'll take our arms open, two big walks forwards, let's go. One, two, open the arms, squeezing in the stomach muscles, back arm. Downstage arm. Okay, here we go, find the balance. Staying there, rising up, close it behind. Pitter patter round, changing feet, bury backwards, stand tall. Here we go, second side. Walk one, walk two. Open the arms and stay. Upstage arm, one, downstage arm. Okay, long arms, reach to the back wall with that foot. There's your arabesque line. Okay, rising up, close it into the back. Pitter patter around. Bury back. Okay, we're halfway through. Keep going. Keep the elbows lifted. Give your arms a workout. Stomachs in. One, two, three. Okay, ready? Let's lift that leg up off the floor. Stretch it behind you. Straight knees. Bury round. Bury backwards. Okay, this is the last time, so I'm not going to say anything. Here we go. So it's better to lift your leg off the floor but at a lower height, but have your body in the correct placement and your knees straight rather than trying to get the leg up but it all being wrong and turned in, because you're going to give yourself an injury that way, okay? So keep everything in the correct placement but keep it lower and correct. Okay, let's go on. We are going to do one tendu exercise, and I'm going to actually today, because it's Friday, and we're gonna go for it. I'm gonna incorporate a pirouette into it, because we can. So what I will say before we do a pirouette, because I don't think I've done one in one of these classes yet, be really careful with the space around you. So ensure you have enough space, okay? It's gonna be very simple, but just be careful. If you have never done a pirouette before, give it a go. If you are someone who dances at a high level and you want to go for a double or a triple, go for it, absolutely. Just make sure you've got space. But I will talk you through it if you haven't. So let's start with our feet in fifth position and our arm in second. We're going to go front and close and front and close and side, close in front and side, close behind and back and a close and back and a plie. Releve in fifth. Now, we're going to do one single turn. We're going to be picking up, first of all, our left leg and spinning round to the left. So it will end up looking like this. And place that foot to the back. Okay? So one more time. Two, tendu to the front. Two, to the side. Two, to the back. Plie. Rise up onto tiptoes. And then we're just going to try and spin, pick up that left foot and put it to the back. If that is really confusing for you, just do a pitter-patter and close it to the back, okay? Then, starting with the right foot again, we're gonna go one to the front, One to the side, one to the back, and one to the side. Side, lower, point, close, and a port de bras. So we're ready to do the whole thing on the other side. Then we have two to the front, two to the side, two to the back plie. Rise up onto tiptoes. We're going to spin round to the right this time, picking up that right foot and placing it to the back. Or if you don't wish to do the pirouette on one leg, pitter-patter around like we just did in our adage exercise. Then one to the front, one to the side, one to the front, side and a lower and a stretch, close and port de bras. Okay, let's go for everybody. If you go wrong, it really doesn't matter. The most important thing is that you just give it a go. I know for a lot of you, you will watch dancers or you might have watched some of the other classes and think, oh, I'd love to be able to spin. Just go for it. Remember, what you need to try and think about is having a straight supporting leg when you do that pirouette. And we talk always a lot, I'm talking about it loads in the primary class for the age 5 to 7s, about spotting the head as it's going to stop you from getting dizzy. But I don't want to go into detail with you in this class. Just spin and see how you get on. And let me know how you get on as well. I'm on Instagram here. So let's take it to, this should work for us. Ready, front, close, lovely and slow. Two, now to the side, side, close, side, close, to the back. Okay, let's go, spin. Close behind. One to the front, one to the side. To the back. To the side, close. Now let's change. Side, lower, and stretch. Close, port de bras. Okay, everybody, we're gonna go on the other side. In 5, 6, two to the front. One, keep the rhythm. Two, side, close front, and side, close back, to the back, one, two. Okay, here comes the plie releve. Now this time, we're gonna spin round to the right, spin. Good job, one to the front. Keep that hip back, to the side, close, to the back, one to the side. Okay, close it in, let's transfer the weight. One, two, three, finish with your port de bras. Finish and stay. Yay! Well done, everybody. Let me know how you got on with those pirouettes. That might have been the first time ever you have looked at a pirouette. So really, really well done if you did. If you're dancing on a carpet or a rug, those turns are going to be extra tricky for you. So just be careful. Right, one jump and we will come down to the floor. Four jumps in parallel position. One, two, three, four. Turn the legs out from the hips. One, two, three, four. Four jumps in second, second, two, three, four. Then we're gonna go right, left, right, and a huge change. Right, left, right, jump. So give yourself a little bit of extra energy for that last jump. Back into parallel. Parallel, two, three, four. First, two, three, four. Second, two, three, four. Left, right, left, big jump. And we're gonna do it four times through. Okay, so keep the body nice and upright. Let the arms relax. You don't need to take shape with your arms, but keep feeling nice and light up on the floor. Here we go, everybody. Are you ready? So back into parallel. One. First. Second. Okay, right foot. Right, left. Big jump. Parallel. First. Let the arms swing. Now bring the left foot in front. Jump, parallel, halfway through. Great job, guys. Keep breathing, keep the energy. Good, last time. First, good job. Second, here we go. One, two, jump up. Stop, well done, everybody. Nice work, okay. We're gonna come down to the floor. So bring your mats in if you have one, or down onto your rug or your carpet. Let's come straight down. Okay, I'm actually gonna go sideways on so I can show you. So, sitting on the floor, keep the posture. Don't sit like this. Not yet. Okay, so shoulders back. Flex the toes up. We're going to keep ourselves nice and straight as we go down and give ourselves a nice, big, deep hamstring stretch, everybody. So, arms up. Breathe in. Sternum comes forward. Don't think about your nose. Think about your chest. And keep that coccyx back. Keep your chest lifted. Chest lifted. Hold it here for four counts. You won't be able to go as far for this stretch. Well done. Point the toes down. Great job, guys. And again. So same thing. Flat back. Flat back. Keep the shoulders back. Chest up. One. Two. Three. And four. Well done, everybody. Okay, bring the legs into a frog's position. So if you were watching the little ones class a moment ago, this is exactly what we did. So sitting tall, let those knees bounce down to the floor, sitting up. Now we're going to aim to get our nose down on our toes. Feel the inside thigh stretch. And come up. And again, let's go forwards. Well done, everybody. And come up. Excellent. Take those legs out to what we would call a straddle position. Good. Sitting tall. Let's take our right arm up and over. Reach for that left leg. Don't cover the face. Keep that shoulder back. And up. So you're painting a rainbow up over your head. Well done, everybody. Okay, place your hands down on the floor. We're gonna give ourselves a nice deep stretch now. So walk those hands forwards as far as they can go. The aim here is to try and get the chest on the floor, but go as far as you can without letting your knees bend and walk yourself back up. Well done, everybody. Okay, we're gonna bring the legs together. We're gonna give ourselves a little outside thigh stretch now. So if you can, let's cross one leg over the other leg and take both hands over and behind our body, breathing in, and let the weight of your head carry you down and forward. You're gonna feel a deep stretch on the outside of your thigh. If any of you do yoga, you'll be very familiar with this, I should suspect. And come up. Well done. One more time. Exhale forward. Down you go. And come up. Great job, guys. Tough stretch. Let's go on the other side. So we're going to cross the other knee. If you have any knee pain, knee injury, I probably wouldn't recommend this exercise. Just keep your legs out in a straddle and perhaps keep your forward inside thigh stretch. Well done, let's go again. Exhale, forwards. And slowly come up. Well done, everybody. Okay, cross the legs naturally. If you can't cross the legs, just keep the legs out in front of you. Tall straight backs, hands on knees. Head and neck now, turn it to the side. Side. Front. Side. Front, and again. Let's incline the head, so you're lifting one ear up to the ceiling, and tall, and ceiling, and up. One more time, and up, and incline, and stretch. Okay, we're going to roll the heads. You may wish to close the eyes if you want to relax. We're going to take eight counts each direction. Ready? Here we go. Side. across your body, stretch over the opposite shoulder, and pull, pull, pull. Well done, guys. And the second side. Okay. We're going to stand up now. So nice and gently, nice and slowly, so we don't get dizzy. And pull ourselves up. Okay, feet into a nice parallel second. Let's sweep the right arm up over our body. Now let the left arm draw down your leg. Try to reach the knee and stretch. And come up. Your feet are in parallel, squeeze the stomach in. One, let's go. And up. Well done. Okay, we're gonna take our legs a little wider apart. Twist your body round to the right. Alexa, stop. Let's go down, all the way down. So we're going to try and get the sternum down. So this is a deep hamstring stretch. If you can, hands on the floor. And try and get your nose as close to that shin as possible. And slowly come up on the same angle. Back through the center, second side. Twist. Breathe in. Exhale. Down you go, sternum all the way down to that shin if you can. If you can only get to there, then that's fine. And come up on the same angle. Back in towards the center. Good, feet into parallel. Well done, everybody. Feet into first. Shoulders down and up and down. Two more times. Really relax. Use your breath to help. Okay, take the arms up and back. Eyes up to the ceiling. Okay, we finished with we started with lots of rises, so we'll finish with them. Take shape with the arms. Take the arms forwards and up to fifth. Lower down. Toes together. Well done, everybody. Lift one arm up to the sky. Take your bow to finish the class. Turning the toes out. Point and a curtsy. And stand tall with shape and relax. Well done, everybody. I hope you feel nice for doing that class. Let me know how you got on with the pirouettes as well, because I threw that in. We haven't done that yet in this class. But we will revisit the pirouettes again next week in this class. So if you were dancing in this class and you found it all quite manageable and you were able to get those pirouettes and you'd like to give yourself a bit more of an aerobic ballet workout, then the class I would suggest for you is the mid-level class that I do. I'll be doing the next one on Monday live at 4 o'clock, that's UK time. But if you're watching on the repeats on YouTube, look for the yellow colour. This class, Adult Ballet Stretch, is in blue and yellow is the mid-level. So that's if you found this quite manageable and you want to give yourself a little bit more of a ballet class workout, go mid-level. I do have one class which is slightly more advanced than that, which is the intermediate adult class, but that really is targeting people who are dancing regularly in a studio with a teacher or an instructor and you sort of know a little bit more about your body placement and classical ballet class structure. Okay. Guys, I hope you all have a really, really fantastic weekend. Keep sharing with me all your comments, your videos, your photos. Share them with your friends, add them onto your stories, tag your friends in, don't forget to tag me in. I'm looking at every single one of them. Apologies if I haven't come back to you just yet. It's just taken me a little while to get through them all, but I do look at every single one of them. I can assure you that. So yeah, keep them coming through to me and I will respond to you as best I can in due course. Katie Louise, you are saying thank you. The Wannies, you are saying thank you. Elizabeth Simmons 3, thank you. Pirouette was hard but fun. Good, I like a challenge on a Friday. It was going to be a challenge. So well done for giving it a go. If you are practicing your pirouettes, just remember what I said. Just make sure you've got space because you don't want to slip and, you know, fall into a child's playpen or something. So guys, thank you so much for joining in. Have a super duper bank holiday Friday. Have a fab weekend. And I will see you all on Monday at 10 o'clock for our next Adult Ballet Stretch class. See you then, guys.